In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Inverse Trigonometric Ratios. Our directions for this first section are to find each angle measure to the nearest degree. Now looking at number one, we have the sine of B. We need to isolate our angle B in order to figure out what that measure is equal to. And in order to do that, we're going to need to take the inverse sine. So taking the inverse sine of the sine of B, I will also have to take the inverse sine of 0.4848. The inverse sine of the sine will essentially cancel out. You can think of this almost as taking the square root of some number squared. The square root will cancel out the exponent. So the inverse sine will cancel out sine. So I'll have B equal to the inverse sine of 0.4848. And how we're going to solve this is typing it into our calculator. So make sure you're in degree mode, since we want this answer in degrees, and we're going to take the inverse, I and V, sine, or the arc sine, that's also the inverse sine, of 0.4848. And when we do that, we're going to get 28.99, and since we're rounding to the nearest degree, we're going to round that to 29 degrees. So our solution in number one is 29 degrees. And I'll just make my way down this worksheet, so I'll do 1, 3, 5, 7, and then I'll do 2, 4, 6, and 8 for this first section. So number 3, we're looking at the cosine. So in order to isolate A, we need to take the inverse cosine of both sides. So the inverse cosine of the cosine of A is A, and that's equal to the inverse cosine, or arc cosine, of 0.7431. Typing that into our calculators, the inverse cosine of 0.7431 equals 42.0, which rounds to 42 degrees. So in number 3, our answer is 42 degrees. Number 5, again, we're going to take the inverse cosine or arc cosine of both sides of our equation. So the inverse cosine of A is A, and that's equal to the inverse cosine of 0.5878. Typing that into our calculator, the inverse cosine of 0.5878 is equal to 53.99, which will round to 54 degrees. So 54 degrees is my solution in number 5. And number 7, again, I'm using the inverse cosine in order to isolate that angle A. So the inverse cosine of the cosine of A is equal to A. And if I take the inverse cosine of one side, I have to take the inverse cosine of the other side of my equation. So taking the inverse cosine of 0.4226, inverse cosine of 0.4226, I'll get 65.0, which rounds to 65 degrees. So the cosine of 65 degrees equals 0.4226. Now going back up to number 2, let's work our way through the evens. So if I have the sine of A and I need to isolate the A, I'll take the inverse sine of both sides of my equation. So I'll have the inverse sine of 0.5150 on my right. The inverse sine of the sine of A is A, so I'm going to type in the inverse sine of 0.5150. Typing that into my calculator, the inverse sine of 0.5150, I'll get 30.99, which rounds to 31 degrees. For the cosine of angle W, I'm taking the inverse cosine of both sides. Taking the inverse cosine of both sides will help me isolate that W. So I'll have that W is equal to the inverse cosine of 0.6157. So the inverse cosine of 0.6157 is equal to 51.99, which we will round to 52 degrees. For the tangent of W, we're going to take the inverse tangent. So the inverse tangent of the tangent of W is going to equal W. And we need to take the inverse tangent of the other side of our equation as well. So when we take the inverse tangent of 19.0811, we type this into our calculator the same way we do inverse sine or inverse cosine. We take inverse tangent of 19.0811. So the arctan is equal to 86.9, which will round to 87 degrees. And lastly, in this section, the tangent of W. Again, we're taking the inverse tangent of both sides. So taking the inverse tangent of the tangent of W, we'll get W on the left-hand side of our equation. And taking the inverse tangent of 0.5317, I'll type the inverse tangent of 0.5317 into my calculator and get 27.9. So 27.9 rounds to 28 degrees. So 28 degrees is my answer and number 8. Now in this next part, we're to find the measure of the indicated angle to the nearest degree. So this time they're giving us a diagram. Let's look at number 9. Let's call this angle A. We need to remember SOHCAHTOA so that we know which trig ratio to use. So if this is angle A, the side of 27 is opposite A, and the side of 38 is adjacent to A. So we have opposite and adjacent, so we'll use tangent. So the tangent of A is equal to the opposite side, 27, over the adjacent side of 38. Now we're looking for A in the nearest degree. So now we're going to do exactly what we did in problems 1 through 8. We're going to take the inverse of whatever trig operation we're using on both sides. So taking the inverse tangent of the tangent of A will equal the inverse tangent of 27/38. So the inverse tangent of A is A, and the inverse tangent of 27/38 we'll type into our calculator. We can do the inverse tangent of 27/38, making sure to close our parentheses or making sure that 27/38 is within our parentheses since we're taking the inverse tangent of that fraction. We're not taking the inverse tangent of 27 and then divided it by 38. We're taking the inverse tangent of 27/38. So that's equal to 35.39, which we can round to 35 degrees. So angle A is 35 degrees in number 9. And number 10, again, SOHCAHTOA. We need to see what we're using in order to figure out which trig operation we'll also be using. So let's make this angle X, and relating to this angle X, we're given the opposite side, and we're also given the adjacent side. So again, we're going to use tangent. The tangent of angle X is equal to the opposite side of 9 over the adjacent side of 21. Taking the inverse tangent of both sides, I'll take the inverse tangent of the tangent of X, and I'll take the inverse tangent of 9 over 21. The inverse tangent of the tangent of X is X, so typing the inverse tangent of 9 over 21, or 9/21, into my calculator, I'll get 23.19, which rounds to 23. So 23 degrees is my angle in number 10. In number 11, let's make this angle Y. Again, we're given the opposite and adjacent sides of Y. So we're using tangent. Tangent equals opposite over adjacent. So the tangent of Y is equal to 14, the opposite side length, over the adjacent side length, 29. Taking the inverse tangent of both sides, I'll do the inverse tangent of the tangent of Y, and that's going to be equal to the inverse tangent of 14/29. The inverse tangent of the tangent of Y is that angle Y, and if I type the inverse tangent of 14/29 into my calculator, I'll get 25.7, which rounds to 26. So y is equal to 26 degrees. And if we wanted to, we could also solve for this angle, since we know that this is 90, this is 26, and the sums of a triangle add up to 180. So then we could use the triangle sum theorem if we wanted to solve for this angle as well. However, that wasn't indicated. Our indicated angle was 26 degrees. And number 12, let's write so katoa and figure out what we're going to be using. Let's call this angle x. We're given the side opposite x, and look, we're also given the hypotenuse. So if we're given O for opposite and H for hypotenuse, we're going to be using sine. Sine equals opposite over hypotenuse. So the sine of our angle x equals the opposite side length of 40 over the hypotenuse of 42. So now I'm going to take the inverse sine of both sides of my equation. The inverse sine of the sine of x is x, and I'll be left with the inverse sine of 40 over 42 on my right-hand side of my equation. So typing that into my calculator, the inverse sine of the opposite side length, 40, over the hypotenuse of 42, we'll get 72.2, which rounds to 72 degrees. So 72 degrees is my solution in number 12. In number 13, let's call this angle A. I'm given the opposite side and the hypotenuse. So again, we're going to be using sine. So the sine of A equals the opposite side length, 10 over 39. So next, taking the inverse sine of both sides. The inverse sine of the sine of A is A, and the inverse sine of 10 over 39, or 10 divided by 39, is equal to 14.8, which will round to 15 degrees. So A is 15 degrees in number 13. And lastly, in this video, we'll do number 14, which will finish out the first page of this worksheet. If you haven't already, please click that subscribe button, and also please give me a thumbs up on this video. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. So for this, let's call this angle X. We're given the opposite, and we're given the hypotenuse, since the hypotenuse is always directly across from the right angle. So we can set up using sine. So the sine of X equals 11 over 27, opposite over hypotenuse. Taking the inverse sine of the sine of X, I'll get that X is equal to the inverse sine of 11 27ths. Typing that into our calculator, the inverse sine of 11 27ths is equal to 24.0, which rounds to 24 degrees. So 24 degrees is the last solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 15 through 26.